So here's a question for you. What happens if you use a large language model, no matter if it's ChatGPT, Google Gemini, inside of Cursor, or if you're using an app builder like Lovable or V0? What happens if you use a large language model and you ask it to build a web application with some front end? And I guess many people only build the front end with a large language model, or for many people, a web app seems to be only the front end, and things get tricky once you add a back end, but let's ignore that. You build a web app, you build the front end of a web app. What do you get if you use a large language model for that? Now, you might say broken code, and we've all been there, but modern large language models typically, in my experience, generate decent code for the initial draft. That might not be a super complex app, and at least in my experience, and I guess for many people, the code starts to break once things get more complex. But the first version you get by the AI often works pretty well. And it often also looks quite decent, depending on which model you're using. But especially for these app builders, it's pretty good very often. So that's not what I meant. Instead, what you'll get is, of course, a React app. A React app that uses Tailwind and ShadCN. That's it. That is what you get every single time. And that's a problem. That is a problem for multiple reasons, actually. The obvious problem, I guess, is that if it's only React, then at some point there won't be any competition. And if there is no competition, there might be less innovation in that entire front-end framework area. Now, of course, there are definitely people that might be quite happy if there are less JavaScript frameworks coming up and being published, because we've all been there around 2019. It felt like a new framework was getting published almost every day, and that could be annoying, though you never had to learn them all, but let's ignore that. But having no competition would also not really be great for us, because it is, of course, competition, like everywhere else in life, that drives innovation and that simply brings new ideas. And it's great to have alternatives, because every person has different preferences. For certain tasks, framework A may be better. For other tasks, framework B may be better. I really see no advantages. I really see no advantages in having less choice than more choice. Now, of course, it might not just be React. Angular might still be a thing. Google's using it internally, many big companies are using it, and Vue also, of course, has a decently sized ecosystem. And I'm also not talking about any of these frameworks dying this year or the next year. That's not my point, but innovation will probably be hampered if we only have this one tech stack that is being suggested all the time. There also is another problem related to that. It's not just React and Tailwind and ShadCN and so on. It's specific versions of these frameworks and libraries. And of course, you could say, as new versions of large language models are released, they will upgrade their code suggestions to the new versions of React and so on. Now, that would honestly still not be ideal, because we would probably still have half a year or maybe an entire year or more of delay between a new React version being published and it being picked up by a large language model. So that's still not great. What's even worse, though, is that it's not even guaranteed that future versions of large language models, new models that are being published, that those models would actually start suggesting newer versions of React and so on. It could happen, but it's not super likely, I'd say, unless they're specifically fine-tuned for that, because, of course, these large language models are trained on all the text they see in the internet. So all the code they see in the internet. Well, if more and more code gets generated by these large language models, and that code is based on old versions of these frameworks, guess what's in the training data? It's outdated code, or code that's using outdated versions of frameworks and libraries. So I'm not 100% sure if we'll really get code suggestions or generated code for these newer versions of React and Tailwind. It might happen, but it feels like the models would have to be manually optimized or fine-tuned for that. I might be wrong, but that's just my understanding of how their training process works. They get trained on data, and well, if that data doesn't contain certain features or aspects, then that's not part of the model. Now, of course, there are ways around that problem, though. Even if the training data doesn't contain a lot of React code that uses the latest version, you could, of course, fine-tune models such that they're more likely to reach out to the official documentation of a certain technology they want to use before they start spitting out code, so that they basically load that documentation into their context. So essentially some form of automated RAG. And tools like Cursor could, of course, do that for you. I mean, they already allow you to include documentation as context into your requests, for example, the React documentation or any other kind of documentation that seems relevant. And of course, such tools can also be built such that they leverage large language models to detect for which kind of requests or prompts it would make sense to reach out to these docs, and then do that before they actually react to the prompt and start generating code with help of a model. So that could be solutions around this problem. MCPs can also possibly help with that, since they could be integrated into code editors to build that bridge between the large language model and the extra documentation it might want to use for certain tasks to get information it otherwise doesn't have. But even with solutions like this, I think it's still quite likely that we'll see some outdated code, maybe especially for smaller, less well-known libraries, and that will have less competition, because that problem is not really being solved by the fact that you could preload and use documentation pages in prompts. We'll see if that becomes a problem, but it could be a potential problem. And either way, it's already a problem, in my opinion, that we have this one main tech stack, and that's about it. Now, of course, you can always ask a large language model to use Angular or Vue or whatever else. You can do that. But of course, for one, that requires you to know that this framework exists. It requires you to know that you might want to use that framework for a certain task or application you want to build. So it requires programming knowledge and some degree of experience. So that's a potential problem here. And that, of course, only is an option if we have enough choice, and well, that brings me back to my initial point. If we have this winner-takes-all mentality in a world of large language model-generated code, then the number of technologies we can choose from might simply become smaller over time. And if it's just because certain libraries might not be maintained anymore because it's just not worth it anymore. Of course, it doesn't necessarily have to get that bad. And of course, companies are not suddenly going to throw their Angular or Vue or whatever application out of the window just because large language models generate React code by default. Of course, these things are not suddenly going to disappear, but it's still not an ideal situation, I would say. And it's of course also not just front-end web development. This problem exists in one way or the other in many different domains. If we look at back-end development, we typically get Node Express as a suggestion. For utility scripts, it's Python. And if we leave the world of programming, we of course also typically get some default answer that tends to occur a bit more frequently than alternative answers. And therefore, it's not that hard to imagine that we could end up in a world where we don't really have a lot of choice and where we don't really see the options we have theoretically. I mean, Google search is far from being in a great shape. It's super annoying that the first results are just ads and you have to scroll down quite a bit to get actual results, and due to SEO, we gotta bunch of stupid results there. That's not great, but at least with Google and the old school approach of researching things, you immediately saw that there was more than one way of doing it. You immediately saw that there is not just one single approach or one single product or whatever it is that you have to use. And with large language models, that's not really necessarily the case, depending on what your prompt is, of course. But if you just ask the model to build a web app that does something, you typically don't get an explanation of available choices. You instead get some code, and that code is React, Tailwind, and ShadCN. That's what it is. But these are, of course, just my thoughts, so please let me know what's your opinion on this, and is this also a problem you see, or is it not really a problem for you or for all of us?